Kristen was an answer to prayer. We had gone to doctors and we were unable to get pregnant. We had gone to Boston to specialists. And we were delighted, actually, a friend of ours prayed for us and said, declare that you're going to have a baby. And 1 year and 1 month later, Kristen was born.
She was beautiful. Mm-hmm. God said she was gonna come and she came. And a short while later, we dedicated her to the Lord. And we meant it.
My name is Kristen Plummer. I grew up in Massachusetts.
Kristen was in the church as often as we were, and that was almost all the time, every time it was open, pretty near.
I grew up also going to a Baptist Christian school.
We wanted them to have all of God that they could, and all of the exposure to godly things.
When I was about 13 years old, in the youth group, kids started making fun of me. This girl that I'd grown up with started spreading lies and rumors about me. And
I felt very rejected by that. Eventually, they all were just making fun of me every time I came in there.
And I think that affected her life very, very much. It was difficult for Kristen.
I couldn't understand why these people who I'd grown up with in church, you know, that had rejected me and just tore me down like that.
And it was unfortunate. She would tell me things and I would tell her, trust the Lord.
I didn't want to even go to church anymore. It got to the point where I just, if that was how church people acted, I just didn't want anything to do with it.
There was a particular boy in the youth group, and a friend of ours came to me and said, I overheard that this particular boy is going to sell her some pot tonight. And that was the beginning of finding out about drugs. And at that particular point, she said to me, oh, Mom, I'm not gonna become a drug addict. I just wanna try this.
But I had been seeking to buy drugs. I was seeking, you know, just trying to be accepted because I felt like so rejected by everybody.
And she started climbing out the window in her bedroom and sneaking off to meet friends. And it just began to accelerate.
At 15 years old, I went to visit my sister and they decided it would be better for me just to stay there.
She said, why don't you let her stay and we'll put her in school here. And we'll get her away from those friends and we'll put her in different activities and deter this path that she's on. But it didn't.
And from there, I started drinking a little bit here and there. I started smoking pot. I tried acid, and they realized that I was doing these things and they came down on me really hard. They'd been trying to get me to go to church out there. But I didn't want anything to do with the church. I didn't want anything to do with these people that had hurt me. I didn't want anything to do with God at this point. I just started falling deeper and deeper into this depression, and a lot of times I didn't really show it on the outside, but I was screaming on the inside.
It became evident that the reason we had sent her down to Florida to live with her sister wasn't working out the way we had hoped.
At 16 years old, I had gone back to Massachusetts to visit my parents. And while I was there, I ended up getting drunk and getting high. And I went back to my parents' house and we got into a fight. We were screaming and yelling at each other.
And she told us she hated us and she wanted to die and she was gonna kill herself.
So I went into the bathroom and I took a razor and I started cutting my wrists.
I finally had to break down the door and go in there.
I just didn't care anymore. I just didn't want to live. I felt so rejected by all the people that were supposed to love me, all these people that were supposed to care about me, that I just couldn't take it anymore.
She told us she was going off to college, and
she said, I don't care what you all say. I'm not going to listen to anything. When I get away from the home, I'm gonna do my own thing. Nobody's gonna tell me what to do.
I went to University of Florida and I ended up getting straight into the party lifestyle. I was in and out of relationships. I lived a very promiscuous lifestyle. I ended up getting pregnant at 19 years old. I thought that I knew who the father was of the baby because I'd been dating somebody off and on for those 2 years that I'd been in college. I ended up not being his and I was just miserable. This threw me into the darkest place that I've ever been in my life. I hated myself. I felt like, you know, this was just another thing that I had failed at. I just continued just to party, because I thought that this was going to kill all the pain. Cocaine, acid, ecstasy, you name it, whatever, heroin, you put it in front of me, I was going to do it. I had been in and out of jail, in and out of institutions. I was to the point where I was going to kill myself again. I was contemplating suicide. I was planning it out. I had had it with this life. I didn't want to live anymore. I had been sitting on my bed, and I knew that God was drawing me to Him all these years. And this one day, I had been sitting on my bed, and I opened the Bible, and just to any page, and I looked down, and it said, "Because you have turned your back on me, you'll feel nothing but pain, pain, and more pain." I knew that He wasn't condemning me. I knew that I could hear like the love in His voice, like He was saying. He was saying, "Come back to me. If you would just come back to me, I will make it all better. I'm the one that you've been searching for all these years."
And she called me and she said, "Mom, I want to go to Word of Life. Will you come and get me?" She was crying. And we took her over to Word of Life 2 days later. And she went into the program.
Like, I think it was maybe the next day after I came into the center, they have praise and worship in the morning. And I lifted up my hands and I said, "God," I said, "you need to help me. I said, I just don't want to live like this anymore." And as soon as I did that, I saw this vision of Jesus coming up to me. He had a blanket in His hands, and he just wrapped it around me. And He said, it's going to be all right. It's going to be okay. He's like, "I love you. I'm going to change everything in your life. Everything's going to be okay." I'd been searching for this my entire life, and I had finally found it.
And we started seeing changes over a period of a year and a half.
Yeah.
To the point where she is a totally different person.
For so many years, I was searching in all the wrong places, when it was only God that could fulfill that. It was only God that could fill that void.
And it's such a thrill to see God rescue her life the way He has.
He's put a new song in my heart. I have a new confidence that I never had before. I'm writing music, and I'm singing in the church choir and worship team.
She looks like a totally different person. She has the joy and love of God now, and peace, and excitement about living.
There's nothing like His love. His love has put a new creativity, a new happiness, a new joy in my life that I never had before.
Our hearts are filled with gratitude.
Absolutely.
Filled with praise, because God has delivered her.